Hey guys, today I want to talk to you about a free alternative to Magnific, and it's called SupIR. If you go on the website, it says revolutionizing image restoration with cutting-edge large-scale AI. And they give you a few examples of what the upscaled images look like, which this one is insane. So if we look here at landscape image restoration, bring nature to life with image restoration, highlighting the natural beauty in landscape photos. And the details that it brings back is just incredible. Revealing true expressions, enhance every detail for lifelike clarity and portraits. You can see some people have compared Magnific upscaled images to this one, and it looks like this model is winning most of the time. So you can go to the GitHub, scroll down, and you can do an install. It's not too bad. And I want to show you some of the examples along with the captions I use to get the results. Now they have quite a variety of different examples here on the website, but what I wanted to do was do my own real world example to see if they cherry pick the results. So if we go into Photoshop here, we can see I started with this image. And if you know what this is from, leave a comment below. Here's the original image I started with. I did the first pass. Pretty good. You can see the eyes are a little different. Probably not the right texture. Bottom teeth, not the greatest. You can see the side of the baby's head. Same with the eyes here. And then I gave it another pass. You can see the detail of the skin improved. Bottom teeth, I'm okay with that. The eyes look a lot better here. Eyes are not perfect on the baby, but I'd say good enough. Let's go on to our next example. I have quite a few here. And all of these images I generated were pretty much the default settings within SupIR. Here's the prompt I use. A man sitting in a brown chair with a surprised look on his face. He's wearing a white shirt and appears to be in a living room setting. The chair is positioned in the center of the image with the man occupying most of the frame. Now I do notice, we zoom in all the way here, the eyes are not quite perfect. But I just generated these images once each just to see how it would turn out. And his teeth are not the best either. But if you look at the hair, skin detail's great. Let's move on to the next image. If you know this, you're amazing. If you know what this show is, let's zoom in and check out the detail here of this clown. This is what we started with. This is our first render. I do see that it generated the ear off to the side here. That's okay. Actually, don't mind that. It got the inside of his cape here, which is just amazing. So I have two different prompts that I did from the same show. And here's the prompt I used. A clown in a blue and yellow costume with a scary face is standing in a dark room. The clown has a yellow and blue hat, and his face is painted with a scary expression. The costume is blue and yellow, and the clown appears to be wearing yellow face paint. The room is dark, and the clown is the main focus of the image. Even if the teeth aren't perfect, I still love the way this image turned out. You can see the texture of the skin is not bad. Let's move on to the next one, check that out. You already know this is from Are You Afraid of the Dark? Here's the before. And the after. It's just the detail of the fur. It made his ear over here. This is great. Let's check out the prompt. The creature's appearance is quite unusual and intriguing, as it combines elements of both a rat and a human, creating a unique and fascinating creature with piercing yellow, scary eyes, open mouth with scary teeth. Now, if you want to know how I got these prompts, how I came up with them, I use something called LLaVA, and it auto-generates these prompts for me. It says a wolf's head in a human's body, right? And then later in the prompt, combines both elements of a rat and a human. I changed that because I thought it looked a little rat-like, so I wanted to see what would happen if we combine both of them. Now, you don't have to use a prompt for this. It can just spit something out, and usually it's pretty good. But I find if you help guide it, it works even better. Now, if we check out this music video still that I screen grabbed from Bowling for Soup, You can see it adds stubble to the face. Teeth look pretty good, actually. Microphone looks great. The necklace, I think, looks wonderful. It's probably one of the better images I tried. This was on the first try. I'll show you the prompt that I use. The image features a man with red hair wearing a black shirt, wooden necklace, and holding a microphone. He appears to be singing or yelling into a microphone with his mouth wide open. The man is standing in front of a red background, which adds a pop of color to the scene. Let's move on to the next image. This one wasn't necessarily low quality or super low quality like compared to the other images that I'll show as an example. But you can see that it adds detail throughout here. Cleaned up the background a little bit as well. Gets rid of some of the film specs and artifacts. Now this one was a little tricky because I did not use any prompts whatsoever. I left the prompt blank just to see what I would get. And this is my first pass. So if we compare it, it adds a little bit of skin texture. Teeth are a little messed up. And then I did what I called the final image. Teeth are still not great, but look at the texture of the skin. Let's look at the entire image here. Let's compare the final image to the original to see how far we got. Look at how well it cleans up most of the image. The ferns in the back, this chair or coat or whatever this is, his necklace. It tries recreating a tattoo here. And this is using no prompt. In this one, I use more of a vague prompt that I generated with LLaVA. The image features a monster with a scary face, possibly a creature from a horror movie. The monster's face is prominently displayed in the foreground, with its mouth wide open, showing its teeth. The monster's face is white, and it appears to be a mask or a sculpture. The background of the image is blurry, which adds to the focus of the monster's face. So we can see we gained a little bit of detail, especially in the teeth. You can see that it's trying to add some eyelashes here. It did add some kind of weird texture on the ear and the cheek, which I'm okay with. And here, this is more of a logo rather than just a normal image. So we have Keenan and Kel with the trademark, and let's see what this generated. Super clean image. Before and after. Super clean. It did a pretty good job of generating the trademark at the bottom there too, which is surprising. Now this was a very low res image here. You can see the dimensions I had at the bottom. Super clean, turned out really well. Here are the original dimensions of this image. Here's what I generated. For having all these JPEG artifacts throughout the entire image, I'd say this is a pretty amazing generation here. Even if the ear looks a little funky, that's okay because the entire character really does. Go to our last image here. Dimensions, 1200 by 740. Okay. Wow. You can see the texture of the hair looks great. Eyebrows, eyelashes, the wrinkles on the eyes. The microphone looks pretty good. This definitely beats Magnific. I would say go check it out. I just wanted to let you guys know about this cool software that's out. I'll leave a link to the GitHub in the description along with their official website. And I want to mention that this software does have batch upscaling. So you can load all of your PNGs into a folder and process all of them. Like I said earlier, all of the settings that I used were all default settings that make it super easy. You can do it with a prompt or without a prompt. Now we have LLaVA, which helps us generate our prompts. So we have to run it in three parts. Run part one, wait for that to load. Run part two, wait for that to load, and run part three. And for run part three, make sure you select your model. For me, I have a 3090, so I chose 6 for the 24 gigabyte version. These loading times are not real time. I'm speeding them up. And also make sure our model is properly loaded. You can see it up there. Now that we have LLaVA up and running, let's drag and drop our image. And it's very easy. Just click send and it'll start generating your prompt for you. Now, this is just an easy tool to use if you're not really sure how you want to describe your object or subject. And if you're not happy with your prompt, you can always click regenerate. You can upvote or downvote. Usually regenerate can help if you run that a few times. Again, this is not real time. I'm speeding these clips up. And now that LLaVA is done generating our prompt, we can open SupIR. Choose one in one because I have a 24 gig card. All we have to do is drag and drop our image into the left-hand side here. Click stage one run. And then we can enter our prompt. For this example, I'll just write it in manually instead of using the generated prompt from LLaVA. If we scroll down here, we can look at all the different settings. It's very similar to what you would see in automatic 1111, stable diffusion. There are some settings I have not even played around with yet. I haven't touched linear CFG or linear stage 2 guidance, the autoencoder, diffusion data type, color fix type, model selection. So go ahead and play around with those if you want. Like I said in the beginning though, everything I pretty much left on default. You can increase the steps. Sometimes that helped me get a little bit better results and prevent any sort of artifacting that I might have gotten or hallucinations on my character. Some of the images I upscaled 2 or 3 times. And then once you have your prompt, and stage one is finished running, go ahead and click stage two. This will take a little bit of time to process. This is the same process for doing the batch upscaling as well. So on the top, you put all your PNG sequences. On the bottom here, you just make a new folder, name it whatever you want. I always label it output, easy to remember, and choose that for my output. And that's where it'll save the images. This is the output it gave us. Very minimal effort. Also, I did find out they are working on a video model, so you'll be able to do videos pretty soon. They're much more consistent over time. All right, if you like the video, comment. If you want to find out more cool things I'm doing, go ahead and subscribe, and I'll see you later. Thanks for watching.